In this topic, we're going to talk about configuration management utilities. And in particular, what we want to look at is some of the things that we can do within Azure to avoid configuration drift. So let's talk about what that is. And we've mentioned it before in some of our other topics, but you just spent all this time building this great Azure infrastructure. And you want it to stay the same. You don't want it to drift from its original settings and configuration, right? So we have some tools that are out there that can help us. And as my friend Jeffrey Snover always says, just like on a famous episode, he said, make it so. You want to keep it exactly like it was before. So he did some great sessions we haven't seen on Channel 9 on Tech Ed and also MS Ignite this recently at Chicago. So check that out with Jeffrey Snover and DSC. So I want to kind of introduce, I got a little quick, simple diagram here that shows if I'm in the portal and I'm going to create a brand new virtual machine, you get these built-in extensions to help you out here. So first of all, we have some of these things that kind of look like little cookbooks. So they have little cookbooky names. So we have Puppet and Chef, and Kale will talk about that in a little bit about what you can do with that and how those work. But these are extensions you can add to help avoid that configuration drift. But then there's also custom scripts, but in particular, the one that I wanted to talk a little bit about that I had seen from Mr. Snover is a thing called DSC. So DSC stands for Desired State Configuration. This was a new feature that came out in Windows Server 2012. So if you know, a lot of you are probably use PowerShell, and if not, I hope so. And in particular, please use the PowerShell ISC, which is baked into Server 2012. It gives you all the options, and you know, if you're allergic to code like I am and don't like to type, it gives you a lot of drop-down, fill-in-the-boxes kind of stuff. It's really cool. So you take PowerShell, which is some basic scripts, and then you go to the next iteration. You can go to Workflows, and then you go another step, which is Desired State Configuration. So as I mentioned, I have all these servers built. If it deviates, something changes, I want it to revert back the exact same state it was before. And so we did a presentation for a customer not too long ago on this, where we had set up again a federation farm with a couple ADFS servers and web application proxy servers. And after these were deployed, we want to make sure they stayed the exact same way and didn't change or deviate. So if someone came in and maliciously changed something or accidentally some configuration got changed, guess what? It would detect those changes and then reset it back to its normal state. Okay, so I'll let Kale talk a little bit about it.
Go ahead, I have some questions about DSC. So on the DSC side, I understand that it can detect and it can also like revert back to what the known state was or what it should be. So how does that is that in like JSON format, or you know, we use JSON for a lot of different things here. Is that similar with PowerShell DSC, or how are these templates that we keep talking about with DSC, how do they work?
Yeah, again, not being a developer myself, I'm not exactly sure, but I'm pretty sure it has to do more with PowerShell workflows.
Okay.
So that's the way I've seen some of the product group work with that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and kind of to dovetail in from the DSC, we also have, and he had it on the screen there, he mentioned a minute ago, the custom action scripts, I believe they're called. Yep. So these custom scripts that we can run as part of our VM agent. Now, keep in mind, this VM agent is kind of like a little broker for us that runs up there in Azure as a Windows service. So what we can do is basically take a PowerShell script that could detect a certain thing. So let's, for instance, use a use case that I ran into was IIS. Can we tell if IIS is installed on this machine? Right. Very simple use case. So can we do that? We could do it with DSC, but we could also write our own PowerShell script to do that. And then we could take that, upload it to an Azure Blob store, put those storage keys in our script that is going to get triggered by our custom script here, and then we could tell it to target certain machines. Uh-huh. So that it would run that script in the context of all those VM agents out there on those VMs and check to see whether the actual, whatever we're checking for, in this case IIS, was installed. It could be ASP.NET, it could be other server configuration type things. And so in that way, we're kind of forcing back to that known state of config. Not quite as templatized as DSC, it's more of a script-based thing, but works pretty well. The other ones that came along there that he mentioned were Chef and Puppet, which are open source alternatives to these types of tools. They've been around for a while, they've been established. I've worked personally a lot with Chef. And with Chef, it's kind of funny because they use the nomenclature of like cooking, but you build recipes. And so these recipes are, for instance, a SQL server. the use case I had was, we want to make sure that SQL is installed in this manner. Here's where the log file should be stored. Here's where the data file should be stored. Here's what version of SQL we should use. All those different things. So we could feed that into a big, giant configuration in Chef. That becomes our recipe for SQL Server. Yeah. And then we can use that to target machines. And then we have a Chef management server that manages all these recipes that get targeted out to our infrastructure. Puppet works in a similar fashion. I haven't had the opportunity to use it as much.
And there's a bunch of those out there, right? So you can literally go search for these things.
Oh, yeah.
They're just readily available.
Because it's an open source product, GitHub is full of recipes out there. We also have a lot on the Microsoft side from the DSC side and custom scripts too. So if you take a look on GitHub, you'll see a lot of that stuff out there. And the one final one that's kind of upcoming now, we kind of alluded to in some of our other topics, is ARM. So ARM is around this same kind of concept, right? So we're able to provision these things out there. Not so much about, you know, reverting these things back, but being able to templatize our workflows or our assets that are provisioned out there into Azure. So I just wanted to drop that in there as well.
So the other thing I was thinking about what you're talking too, when we were talking earlier about Operations Manager and kind of monitoring things, well, if we have something that's self-monitoring and self-healing and annealing itself, right, that almost kind of reduces the workload of having an Operations Manager. We don't have to worry about all those alerts and having to fix it. Once we see something wrong, it fixes itself.
Yeah, it's self-healing infrastructure. That's what we're after. Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, so that concludes our topic on configuration management utilities.